Hi guys, before I begin, I'd like you to know that this is a continuation of the previous video and employs the same scenario to demonstrate when and how to use the Array Aggregator. It is highly recommended to go over the first video to better understand the context and references. Let's begin by looking at the output of the Array Aggregator. It is an array comprised of two parent collections, each of which contains a single child collection called product. And if you look at the input, there are two bundles and each bundle contains a collection product. So my objective here is to extract the product collection from both the bundles outputted by the iterator. Let's look at the setup of the array aggregator. Here, the source module is iterator because I want to aggregate its output. The target structure remains custom, and under aggregated fields, I've selected product as that is the only field I wish to aggregate. Moving forward, I want to store in a data store the values of all the elements from both the product collections. To do that, I've used another iterator on this route and mapped the output of the array aggregator. And this iterator outputs two separate bundles of data, each only containing the product collection along with its items and their values. And this is the data store that only contains these three items: product name, product size, and product quantity. And I've mapped the respective elements in each of the fields. Since there were two bundles, two separate operations took place and created two records in the data store. And this is what the data store looks like. Lastly, I've got the same data store here, but let's say I want to store the values of only the second collection outputted by the array aggregator, ignoring the first collection altogether. In that case, I have to normally map the elements in their respective fields. And here's the tricky part. I need to hover over each element and change the index to the corresponding collection. As you see, I've done that already, and therefore the module outputs a single bundle. You can also see it here on the data store. So that's it. You only need to keep in mind that the array aggregator aggregates multiple bundles of data into a single array containing collections of specified items. In other words, the array aggregator returns one bundle of data with multiple collections, each corresponding to a bundle generated by the source module, which refers to the module whose output you wish to aggregate. We've now covered the fundamentals of iterators and array aggregators. In the next video of this lesson, I will explain how the subsequent module after an array aggregator affects the target structure of an array. See you there!